My name is Lance Berry, and I'm the product manager for our transmission and substation connectors at Hubbell Power Systems, and this is In Depth. This video details out the different strength ratings associated with our quadrant bolted dead end clamps in the transmission and substation product offering. These clamps are typically referred to as our SD clamps, our PG clamps, and our BSD clamps. A quadrant bolted deadend clamp can be manufactured from cast aluminum, ductile iron, or bronze. The clamp is a range-taking device that accepts multiple conductor sizes. The clamp has three primary design features: the clevis, the sag eye, and the cable groove. Each one of these design features have their own associated strength ratings. Bolted deadends primary application is to hold the tension of the line, or commonly referred to as the conductor, to the tower structure, so strength ratings are critical. The first strength rating we are going to discuss is related to the cable groove. We will be referencing the industry standard ANSI C119.4 for this rating. This is the ultimate tensile test and relates to the conductor being used. ANSI C119.4 tells us that the bolted deadends can be rated for partial tension, which is class 2 or 40% of the conductor rated breaking strength, or for normal tension, which is class 1A or 60% of the conductor rated breaking strength. Each conductor or power line cable has a strength rating associated with it as well. Deadends can hold a percentage of that strength rating. When an ultimate tensile strength is labeled as class 2 per ANSI C119.4, the deadend will hold 40% of that conductor's strength. If the conductor has a strength of 10,000 pounds, then the bolted deadend is rated for 4,000 pounds. Testing a bolted deadend for its ultimate tensile strength rating consists of putting two deadends in a test bed. One is called the anchor side and one is called the pull side. Torque the bolts to the appropriate torque rating for the conductor and mark the conductor at the start of the cable groove to identify the location on the clamp before the test. Pull the deadends until a slip occurs and record the strength rating when the slip first occurred. The next strength rating associated with the deadend is in relation to the clevis. This is also referred to as the ultimate body strength. This focuses on the strength of the component body. This portion must be rated higher than the largest conductor size in the cable range. The ultimate body strength will always be permanently marked on the component. The standard used for this strength rating is IEEE C135.61. The test setups are located in this specification. The last strength rating associated with a bolted deadend is referred to as the sag eye ultimate strength. The sag eye is the loop on the bolted deadend and is used for taking tension off the line so linemen can install the deadend. The lineman will use a come along and put a hook into the sag eye to remove tension from the line. Since this is a mechanical load and bolted deadends must be able to withstand, this also has a strength rating. The sag eye ultimate strength is rated at 60% of the ultimate body strength of the deadend. This test setup is also located in the specification IEEE C135.61. Thank you for watching this video about bolted quadrant deadends. For more information, please contact either your customer service representative or the territory manager. Thank you.